stays with children long after the trauma is over. If you've experienced childhood trauma, then what I'm about to tell you won't come as a surprise. But if you haven't, then whatever you think you know about childhood trauma, I assure you, it is far worse than you could ever imagine. Our children were between the ages of 7 and 12 when we adopted them. People ask me sometimes if they remember their biological family, and the answer is yes. These are memories they couldn't forget even if they tried. The abuse that they endured was horrific. Some of my children have scars where their body was burned with a lighter, or broken bones that never healed correctly. One with a traumatic brain injury. One child came to us at half the weight of a typical 7th grader. The kids have been starved, and it's a miracle that they even survived. Our kids have had a lot of issues that they've struggled with. A couple of my kids have reactive attachment disorder, fetal alcohol syndrome, post-traumatic stress disorder, just to name a few. All of these conditions are a result of trauma and abuse, and they manifest in different ways, from very severe destructive behaviors to suicidal thoughts. I spent a lot of years reading every therapeutic parenting book that I could find and praying that my children could get better. This desire for my children to heal is the reason why I joined forces with Anika and Angela to do Jacob's Law. We knew that these kids needed therapeutic interventions that they simply weren't getting. We had no political experience whatsoever, and it was, again, one of those moments where we strongly felt that we needed to do something despite our shortcomings and despite whatever we lacked as far as experience. We felt called to stand up for these precious children who had been abandoned and abused. Tomorrow will be the 2-year anniversary since the governor signed Jacob's Law into law. While we were able to affect thousands of children with Jacob's Law, there's still more work to be done. There's lots of children in kinship and guardianship situations that don't have access to services through the state, or youth who have aged out and don't have a strong support system. We want to stand in that gap. We want to provide support to the youth and families who may not know about other resources available and make sure that no child falls through the cracks. Starting ASA Now was one more time when we felt called to do something that was bigger than ourselves. Through our success and through our failures, we've learned so much that we can use to help other families. Since starting ASA Now, we've been able to serve over 1,600 children. We provide respite care for foster and adopted families, life skills and classes for teens, birthday parties for children in foster care, family get-togethers, support group meetings, couples retreats, trauma mama retreats, meals for kinship families, community events, back-to-school backpacks, visits with therapeutic animals, emergency food and clothing to families in need, Christmas gifts for kinship families, education and training, advocacy and connections to community resources. Jacob's Mission Community Center will be a place where we can continue what we are already doing, but it will go far beyond that. We will be able to expand resources to foster kinship, adoptive, and biological families. We'll be able to provide children with access to things we cannot currently provide, such as brain-based interventions like Legos and dance classes, both of which help to rewire and heal the brain after trauma. Everything we've done so far and everything that we continue to do is with the belief that we can strengthen families as we help children overcome trauma and give parents some therapeutic skills to have in their toolbox. Jacob's Mission Community Center will be a safe haven and a place of healing for many foster and adopted families, but we cannot do this without your donations. Every dollar that is donated will directly benefit children in our community. For $1,000, we can provide a month's worth of dance lessons for 60 children, or 20 Lego sets that can be used for therapeutic play. Not a day goes by that ASA Now doesn't hear from at least one foster or adopted parent whose child is in crisis. These cries for help come in at all hours of the day and night. Every single one breaks our heart. We can hear the pain and voices of these foster children, or of these foster and adopted parents, as they tell us they don't know how they can keep going, and they begged and pleaded for help in meeting the needs of their children, but there's still pieces of the puzzle that seem to be missing. Sometimes it's a matter of pointing them to the right resources that nobody has told them about yet, Often we listen to their stories and think, if only this child could have had this therapy. Or if only this family had known about this service when their child was first placed in their home, things might not have progressed to this point. Jacob's Mission Community Center will bring together, under one roof, an unparalleled pool of support, resources and training in a way that does not currently exist anywhere else in the state of Arizona. The programs and services we plan to provide will create solid foundations upon which families can build brighter futures for their foster and adopted children. We're very excited to open this community center, and we are filled with hope and joy as we think of the positive impact this center will have in our community and in the years to come. We hope that each of you feels called to join us in this effort. From the start, this community center has been a community effort. We do have the power to stand together, to make a difference, and to change lives. The fact that you are here today says that this matters to you. So I'll close with thank you for being here today.